Alrighty, folks, so I just warmed our test mower up, and there we go. Draining the oil out of it now, sitting on an oil drain pan, to make sure we get it all out. And here's what we're testing today. Basically some old car wax that I got laying around. We're gonna see, will it lubricate? Yeehaw. We'll see what happens. Maybe we'll seize up solid. This one, I really have no idea. My hypothesis is that it's probably going to seize within 10 minutes. But I don't know. Hard to say. I'm just going by that, by like the way that you apply wax to a car, how it kind of gets chalky, it chalks up. I think that's going to happen between the bearings. However, there may be enough in there that it doesn't, so who knows? Stick around and find out as soon as we make sure we get all the oil out of this thing. All right, guys, so I got the camera set up. I have got our wax measured out and ready to go. All shaken up and everything. Now, after every video I do of will it lubricate, I drain out whatever we're testing, and I put in regular conventional engine oil again and flush it, and like run it and flush it, and so what I drained out of here today still smells like the hand lotion, skin moisturizer, which is the last thing that we tested. And it's kind of it's still kind of oilish colored with a little bit of, you can see like the white kind of tinging to it, made it kind of gray, I guess, with the hand lotion. There you go. That's pretty well all of it. And seemed to be a little bit of a metallic in it as well. So who knows really what's all going on with that, if it's been eating the engine at all. There it is there. Cool, all right, let's fire this thing up. Get the dipstick back in. No sense in checking oil, because obviously you're checking the wax, because I did measure it, but also it's probably a little thick to work with a dipstick. So here we go. What I'm going to do is, of course, I'm going to take temperature readings with my handy dandy temperature gun, and I'm going to run it at about the regular lawnmower engine speed. I'm going to crack full throttle a little bit, as well as then when we're ready for shutdown, I'll do idle. So it is 225 now in recording, and I'll keep an eye on that. We're gonna run it for 10 minutes. So here we go. Here's the choke.
Thank you. already dropping. There we go. Very hot exhaust temp. Exhaust temperatures have actually cooled. Still going. going. We're at 7 minutes. If she can hold on, 3 more minutes. It's success.
Ew. And that's all that came out. Out of all we put in. So that means there's a lot of it that has hardened up. I'm thinking probably in the piston rings because the compression is absolutely horrible. There's almost none. And probably in the valves. So who can guess what our next video is going to be?
So that's on the low speed idle. That's as low as she goes. And as you can hear, not even a knock, and that's just with a little bit of regular oil back in it. So it does still run really good, so we can use this engine again for another test. But now I have an idea for the next video. So let me tell you about it. Okay, so my hypothesis was that this was not going to last 10 minutes and that it was going to seize up solid. It did not. It came very close though. And then after draining the wax out of the crankcase and running a small amount of regular oil, not the actual amount that's supposed to be in the engine, just put a small amount of regular oil back in, it fired right up and runs perfectly fine now. However, this engine does have very little compression in it. And I knew that even yesterday, when it had regular oil in it, I warmed it up, did a compression test, we only had 60 PSI of compression, which is extremely low, and it is a smoky engine. So, you guys can probably figure out what I'm going to do for a test on the next video, which will be coming soon. I'm trying to get back into this again after having, obviously, a long break with life changes and so on. So, here we go. Let's get her done. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Even though nothing spectacular happened, I really thought it would this time. Geez, I ran so much crap through this particular engine and we've had no issues so far. This was the closest we got to it seizing up, and even if it were to seize up, it would have just locked. It would have been anything spectacular. When this thing goes, I want it to be awesome. I want to see engine guts everywhere. Kind of good that didn't happen in here though. If that happens, I want it to be in the backyard just because I have, you know, the Harleys are in here, so probably think that one through next time. And until that next time, cheers and beers. Later, guys.